Labą dieną. Labai malonu matyti tokį didelį naujausiomis tendencijomis besidominčių žmonių būrį. Šiandieną tikrai daug nedaug žodžiausių. Juk turime net 8 puikius pranešėjus, kurie yra paruošę beprotiškai įdomias temas, kurias apžvelgsime konferencijos metu. Taigi pirmasis pranešėjas bus iš įmonės Isku baldai Antti Olin.
So, good afternoon. My name is Antti Olin. I'm a furniture designer and interior architect from Finland, from Helsinki. And I'm also the design director for a company called Isku, which is the biggest furniture company in Finland. And today, for this 20 minutes time, I will open up a little bit about an issue called innovation as a source of design. And especially I will talk about material innovations, because that's really something that's close to our everyday life as a designer and part of product development. So this is a nice image because Finland is covered with forests. Actually 80% of our country is covered with forests, and then 10% is covered with freshwater, meaning lakes. So this, we are pretty much living in the middle of forests. So wood is something that is really important for us Finns also, and especially for us Finnish designers. So I will talk about wood as a material that we use a lot. This is jumping, but Isku is fairly old company, so we are turning 90 years old next year. So we were founded 1928, and as you see in the picture, even the factory and the headquarters is surrounded with woods, and this is in Lahti, which is about 100 kilometers north from Helsinki. And it's owned by a family called Wikström, and our personnel nowadays it's getting closer to 800, and the size of the company is about 160 million euros. That's turnover that's going to be this year, 2017. So wood as a material, it's really important. It's really, really, we are surrounded with it. We kind of live and breathe from the forests and this material. And this is it's jumping always like 2 slides. But anyway, this is really the starting. And actually the guy on the left-hand side is the founder of Isku, year 1928. And they were really skilled at craftsmanship and doing really a lot of solid wood furniture. And this is what it is nowadays. It's really, really based on still the same material, still on the wood material, but really new technologies and material innovations. And this is a simple picture. I was challenging one of our freelance designers to create something new from heat-formable plywood. And there's a sheet that's opened up there in the corner, and these are fresh and new ideas from a freelance designer called Mikko Laakkonen. And the idea was to challenge him to create a chair from a heat-formable plywood called Grada. It's a new material, it's a new innovation that we came up in Finland together with a big forest industry company called UPM. And then there comes the designer's ideas, and then we go pretty quickly to the factory to test, make sketch models and prototypes. So there is still a lot of hand making and a lot of good craftsmanship to test these and see how it's working and how it's possibly done then with real molds. And there are some images of how this product, for example, was born. There's the sheet. So the idea is that first you cut the form, you heat it up to 120 degrees, and then you put it in a cold mold and you have a ready piece of furniture. Because the old way, the way that all the bent plywood products have done since Alvar Aalto and Fritz Arne Jacobsen and Charles André Eames from the 1930s and so on, is that you have a thin layer of wood, you have glue, another layer of wood, and then you end up with a package of thin layers of wood and a lot of glue in between, and then you put it in a hot mold, and then you get the shape, and then you cut everything off that you don't need. So there is a lot of overwaste material, so this is much more efficient and ecological and also really solid in many ways. So this is the idea as it was a few years ago when we came up with this product. I'm standing there on the left-hand side, and the freelance designer on the right-hand side, and that's the form, and that's the chair, how it was created from this new material. So this is, as I mentioned in the starting, this is the subject of my 20 minutes, the innovations in design. And then we have nice forms, nice product, and this is the chair. And this is what the factory looks like nowadays. So it's quite far from the black and white picture that I showed in the early stages. highly automatized because we want to have the production in Finland, so we have to raise the level of automatization. So it's it could be even a car factory or something like that. But this is the production line, how we produce nowadays our chairs. So the pieces goes into that first box, which is just heating up the sheet, and then you cut it into forms, and then they come up from these. There's two places for molds, so it's quite rapid and fast also to get these products out. A really simple example how a product is born, and this is something that I know really well because it's my design, and I just shortly tell you how the product is born from the first sketches to the final product. So first pen and paper, because that's the fastest way to get the ideas to the paper, and the simple task was to design a high level meeting room chair using this Grada heat formable plywood material. So pen and paper is still the fastest way, but then you go pretty quickly back to the computer because then you have 3D images, so it's easy to show all the color combinations and materials and so on. And then this is the most crucial part, even it's not that good looking, but it's anyway when you're designing a three-dimensional object as a furniture piece, it has to be checked from every angle and all the ergonomics and so on has to be taken in consideration. So this is an important part. Then back to the computer again, making some pictures for the molds. Then again, good craftsmanship. You need a lot of hands. You need to make the first prototypes. So I can just show these rapidly, how we make the first plywood presses. This is the first ones. This is not the real one yet, but this is then the room that every designer hates, because this is where they try to break everything nice and thin that we have created and designed. But of course, it's really important to test it in this level, and it's not coming back as a reclamation then later from the end user. But it's good to test it in the early stage. Some pictures from the test laboratory. And then you have to believe in the product, and then you buy this expensive aluminium mold, which is a price of a German car. So it's quite expensive. You really have to believe into the product that you're going to sell it a lot so that you can pay off the mold and the expenses. And then this is the material innovation that we came up at this stage, that we tested different kind of materials that you can press at the same time in these forms. And copper and brass are naturally antimicrobial materials. We tested them because they are good looking. It was a nice thing to have in these armrests. It looks good, it's a trendy color and so on, but it's also antimicrobial material. So we came up with a totally new segment, Isku Health. We have now assortment of furniture that are totally antimicrobial and based on the materials. So first, of course, the copper and brass in the armrests, but then we were looking for different kind of fabrics with silver in it and powder coats and lax and everything. So nowadays we have a really huge assortment of products under the label Isku Health, and that's the fastest growing business in our area at the moment. So it's a good and important kind of how an innovation can grow your business and what kind of things you can find from material innovations. So that's an example of one, and now there's a big product series, and actually everything that we do nowadays are based on this Grada material, and everything can be antimicrobial, so it's really a big business for us nowadays. And one really nice story, ecological values are really important, so how can a product be born from an ecological point of view? We do a lot of upholstered furniture in our factory in Lahti, so there is also a lot of overwaste material, and we used to give it away, and it was used as energy waste and so on. But nowadays, everything that is coming from our factory, this soft material, we crush it into small crumbles and we press it into big block. And one of our in-house designers' task was how to use that overwaste material. And really simple story, he cut it into these shapes, and now we have a product that we actually sell pretty well, and the story is really nice because it's totally done from overwaste material. And of course you can have in whatever fabrics and colors and so on, but it's also again good design based on material innovation and even a nice ecological story behind it. We always challenge the young designers to look for new ideas, and this is a group of design students and their ideas what they could create from heat formable plywood. And there's a couple of these that we are now taking further to see if there's something that we really need to our portfolio and something that we really believe in. But it's always good to have the eyes open for new ideas and innovations. And quite often they come from the young generation, from the design students and architect students and so on. And this is another good example of, again, group of design students in our factory seeing what kind of materials we use and what's possible to make. And actually, one girl came up with this simple idea of seat puffs that you put on the magnet on the wall. So it's a simple idea, and everybody fell in love with it when they saw the first prototypes, and now we have sold it for several years. And everybody loves it, the architects and designers, because it's so nice and colorful. You can use it in the school corridors and in office buildings and so on. And the cleaning people love it because you can just throw it away from the floor when you don't use it. And the wall panel is also acoustic, so it's also sound absorbing, so it's damping the sound, which is really important, especially in learning environments. So that's a simple idea from a student. And again, really, really good story behind it. Now, Finland is celebrating 100 years independence. Actually, our official Independence Day is next Wednesday. And to celebrate 100-year-old Finland, we organized a design competition, and we had 133 good ideas. And there is just, I can scroll them through, but quite many ideas were based on this heat-formable plywood. And it's always good to have design competitions when you get a kind of an overview of what the young and also older designers are thinking and what's trendy and what's going on at the moment, and a lot of good ideas and innovations behind these ideas that they sent to us. And we chose 10 different products that we made prototypes, and then afterwards we came up with this is the winning proposal. And it was actually a chair, again, based on this heat-formable plywood, even though it's upholstered and it's inside there. And the story behind it was so nice, because it said that let's celebrate 100-year-old Finland with a big hug, and the chair's name is Big Hug. So that was the winning entrance. So I probably didn't use 20 minutes because I was running this through, but anyway, that was my last slide, so maybe I left some 5 minutes or something. And then just to remind you that in the bag when you leave you have this kind of a small paper, and check it through, because there's a proposal for all your designers and architects to join our designer network, and it's read it through, so it's good information in it. But that was my presentation, so thank you very much.
Ir antroji mūsų pranešėja yra Sigita Vlasevičienė, kuri pristato temą, ar vanduo visuomet teikia tik džiaugsmą.
Labą dieną, esu Sigita Vlasevičienė ir mano šiandien toks keistas klausimas jums apie tai, ar vanduo visuomet teikia tik džiaugsmą. Iš tikrųjų, tai yra tema, norėčiau pristatyti groja inovacijas. Kažkam turbūt šitas vaizdas nekelia tokios šypsenos kaip jums. O toliau, kalbėdama apie inovacijas, noriu pradėti nuo pačios Groja. Tai Groja yra santechnikos lyderis pasaulyje, ir tai yra vienas didžiausių ir garsiausių prekės ženklų, kurio įkvėpimo šaltinis yra vanduo. Ir šiandien trumpai noriu papasakoti, kaip inovacijos ir vandens poveikis žmogui bei visuomeniai susijęs. Tai visų pirma, norėčiau pradėti apie įtaką. Iš tikrųjų, įtaką galima daryti vandeniui, per vandenį žmogui, ir tai rodo naujausias ir nesenai gautas prieš porą mėnesių Groja apdovanojimas ar įvertinimas. JAF žurnalas Fortune paskelbė top 50 su labai garsiu pavadinimu. Tai yra top 50 kompanijų, kurios keičia pasaulį. Labai garsu, labai skambu, ir Groja yra vienintelė santechnikos kompanija papuolusi į šį 50, tarp tokių kompanijų kaip Apple, netgi aplenkusi kompaniją IBM. Kodėl, už ką ir kaip? Tai Visų pirma, tai yra du pagrindiniai produktai, dvi inovacijos, absoliučios inovacijos, kurios padėjo patekti. Pirmoji yra GrowEssence. Čia kuriate ne tik pastatus, interjerus, jūs kuriate namus, kuriate erdves, kuriuose gyvena žmonės, valgo, miega, sapnuoja, svajoja. Ir staiga dėl tam tikrų priežasčių, dėl kažkokio nelemto atsitiktinumo, visa tai, visas tas jūsų triūsas, daugelio naktų darbas, taiga gali būti sugriautas. Ir GrowEssence tai yra mažas detektorius, maža tabletė, kurie praneša jums, ne tik pipsėdama ir rėkdama, bet ir atsiunčia į jūsų mobilų telefoną, kad kažkas yra ne taip, kai pajaučia po savim vandenį. Tačiau įsivaizduokim situaciją, kad jūs esate labai toli, tarkim, dabar apkalbėtum, daug kalbamame Balyje ir gaunate tokį pranešimą į telefoną, o vieninteliai raktai nuo buto ar namo yra su jumis. Kas tuomet? Taigi, tokiu atveju reikia tikėtis, kad jūsų namuose ar jūsų klientų namuose yra sumontuota dar viena groja inovacija, GrowEssence Guard. Tai yra išmanus renginys, kuris montuojamas ant vamžių ir gali pajutęs, kad vamžiuose yra nuotėkis, didelis nuotėkis, jisai sustabdo vandenį ties padavimu. Taigi, taip išvengiate didelės žalos. Ir visa šita sistema, tai yra groja inovacijos nuo vandens žalos. Iš tikrųjų, jeigu kalbam apie statistiką, tai yra jaudinanti, nes daugiau negu pusė šeimų yra susidūrusių su vandens žala. Vokietijoje per metus užregistruojama daugiau negu 1 milijonas atvejų sukeltų dėl vandens išsiliejimo. O įdomiausias skaičius turbūt yra tai, kad 93% šių atvejų buvo galima išvengti. Taigi, toliau, kita grohe inovacija, kuri padėjo patekti į Fortune Top 50-uką, kaip keičiamas yra pasaulis. Grohe Blue Home. Jeigu žiūrint taip labai paprastai, tai yra elementarus virtuvinis maišytuvas. Ir kaipgi virtuvinis maišytuvas gali padėti pakeisti pasaulį. Visų pirma, tai jisai turi dar tokią papildomą funkciją, kaip tyra, sveika, šviežia, negazuota, lengvai gazuota arba stipriai gazuota mineralinį vandenį tiesiai iš čiaupo. Ir jūs turbūt esat girdėję daug, kalbant apie ekologiją, dabar labai irgi paplitusi frazė, kad su konkrečia data net, kad 2050 metais vandenynuose bus mažiau žuvų nei plastiko butelių. Vėlgi visi daug kalba, o kas iš tikrųjų yra daroma ta linkme. Tai žiūrint labai primityviai, žmonės kaip ir būtų linkę gerti vandenį iš čiaupo, bet nenori eiti į kompromisą dėl skonio. Šiuo atveju groja Blue Home netgi akluose testuose pranoko pačius garsiausius mineralinio vandens gamintus. Tad toks sprendimas padėtų sutaupyti plastiko, nereikalautų naudoti tiek daug plastiko ir be abejo turim galvoti ir apie savo sveikatą, apie savo nugarą, kiek mums užtrunka, kiek mums sunku yra nešioti tos plastiko butelius. O be to tai yra paprasta, tiesiog vieno paspaudimo mygtuku mes turim negazuotą, lengvai gazuotą arba stipriai gazuotą vandenį. Ir turit sutikti su manim, kad šiai dienai nėra sveikesnio gėrimo nei vanduo. Na, nebent šiandien tą šaltą rytą buvo žalelio arbata. Ir tuo taip pat pristatau dar vieną inovaciją, tai yra jau antroji karta Groja Red. Taip pat elementarus virtuvinis maišytuvas, tik su papildoma virdulio integruota funkcija. Tai reiškia, kad jūs turite ne tik virtuvės maišytuvą, bet ir paspaudę keletą mygtukų kombinaciją, jūs turite verdantį vandenį tiesiai iš čiaupo. Ir tai yra saugiausias virdulys šiuo metu pasaulyje, be to tai yra energetinės klasės virdulys. Na, taip mes vadiname boilerį, kurį montuojame po plautuvę. Kalbant apie poveikį žmogui, taip pat būtina paminėti gerą dizainą ir estetiką. Tai yra ganėtinai sunkiai išmatuojamas poveikis, nes tarkim vandens taupimą ganėtinai lengva suprasti, pamatuoti ir vertinti, o estetinis poveikis, kurgi jis, visi čia sėdintys puikiai suprantam, kad jisai tikrai nėra mažiau svarbus. Bet mūsų pagrindinis dizaineris Michael Siem yra pasakęs, kad labai svarbu yra ne tik tai, kaip daiktai atrodo, bet ir kaip malonu bei patogu jais naudotis. Tai reiškia, kad jeigu kalbame apie žmogaus pojūčius, tai yra svarbu ne tik tai stimuliuoti vizualinį žmogaus pojūtį regą, bet taip pat ir lytėjimą. Nuo to priklauso taip pat gaunamų teigiamų emocijų kiekis. Ir štai čia labai geras pavyzdys, naujoji Groja linearė serija, kuri tinka prie įvairių formų, tai reiškia tiek apvalių, tiek kampuotų. Dar viena nauja serija, Groja Essence, kuri turi net 4 papildomas spalvas apart chromo, jos gali būti blizgios ir matinės, apart to, kad tai yra dabar mada ir labai populiarus sprendimas tokios spalvos visame interjere, ir mes galime pasiūlyti labai platų asortimentą, tai reiškia ne tik maišytuvus, dušo, vonios sprendimus, bet ir aksesuarus, taip pat ir VC nuleidimo mygtukus. Bet šiuo atveju dar labai svarbu yra paminėti tą inovaciją, kuris slypi už šio padengimo. Tai yra PVD technologija, ji pasižymi tuo, kad yra 10 kartų atsparesnė įbrėžimams bei abrazyviniam medžiagom nei chromas. Tai reiškia, kad tas daiktas, kurį jūs suplanavote savo kliento interjere, jisai atrodys taip pat naujai daugelį metų kaip ir pačią pirmąją dieną. Ir Essence virtuviniai maišytuvai vaivorykštės spalvų, tai taip pat dar vienas įrodymas, kad komfortas ir geras dizainas neturėtų būti kompromisas. Smart Control dušo sistema, tai buvo paskutinioji inovacija, kurią jums norėjau parodyti. Ir labai trumpai, kas tai yra? Tai yra mechaninis mechanizmas, jam nereikia nei baterijos, nei elektros. Ir tai yra ateities dušas. Mes esame įsitikinę, kad visi dušai ateityje bus valdomi mygtuko paspaudimu. Nes apskritai inovacijos, kurios parodžiau, turi vieną bendrą savybę. Jos yra visos sukurtos tam, kad palengvintų žmogaus būti ir kasdieninius ritualus paverstų patogesniais. O atsakant į pradžią mano užduotą klausimą, taip, vanduo iš tiesų teikia labai labai daug džiaugsmo ir yra sveikatos bei gyvybės šaltinis. Tad reiktų nepamiršti kuo plačiau ir kuo daugiau naudoti inovacijų įrengiant vonios kambarį ar virtuvę. Ačiū jums labai už dėmesį.